company.com.
I hide myself from no one. I know that
it's funny how they make reggae songs out of everything.
This was a ship. This is a cruise ship.
Tom Joyner, we got to get on that.
It's Reach Around Radio.
Get our own cruise.
It's your boy.
Eventually.
Staying focused on the female speed doggy dog in the house.
Oh, God. When
Did you have to reiterate that?
When you say it, you're trying to convince yourself.
Saying no homo.
Yeah. That means you got penis on the mind.
Well.
That means you want a bowl of penne pasta.
Oh, my God. Anyway, who are you?
Speedy. Focused.
Poetess.
Bitches.
Claudia. Niggas.
Teeter. Potato.
Pickles.
Baby.
Oh, a big shout out to John B. Again, John he has B, a bunch man. Of shows coming up. He has on February 24th, Legends Theater in Albuquerque, New Mexico. And on the 15th and 16th, the South by Southwest Festival. Check that out. And Yoshi's in San Francisco, March 28th and April 28th in Phoenix, Arizona at the Celebrity Theater. It is Talent Thursdays, and we're keeping it moving with another guest in the building.
So nice.
Yes.
He's go get the album, y'all. Go get the album.
Go get the album. Comfortable swag.
Treat yourself. Yeah. Don't cheat yourself.
That's right.
On Twitter. I'm sorry, on iTunes. And it's an independent project.
Yes.
So
it's first one.
Support independent music. In the house with us is Miss Marva King. She began her career singing gospel at the early age of 13. She is most known for her starring role in Tyler Perry's multi-million-dollar grossing faith-based DVD, Diary of a Black Woman. And she can be heard on albums with Tupac, Chaka Khan, Lionel Richie, and the purple one himself I've heard you worked with, Prince.
Oh, yeah.
And now she has a long list of accolades, and currently she has a new single out right now that just dropped called Step In. Welcome, Marva King.
Oh!
Hey.
Thank you.
I've been knowing Marva for years.
That's right.
What you know about Marva?
And her hair is luxurious.
It's all good, though, isn't it, Speedy?
But yeah.
Oh, wait a minute.
Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Don't go there.
No, no,
don't
no. There's a backstory.
My woman's intuition.
She always dated them dudes, and you go, look at this, mom.
Oh,
he all in shape.
You mean cute
shit.
Guys?
Whatever.
Guys in shape, he said.
Old, tall, light skin.
Fine, like, nice abs.
But they have good hearts.
Shirt tucked in.
They have good hearts.
Now, has Speedy tried to get at you, and how many times?
You know what? Absolutely not.
Never,
really?
Never.
You
I don't
been
think
just
she's brave enough
we had
for
a platonic.
Marva has mace.
No, big as in success or big
no,
as
big
in
oh,
size?
No. He likes big size.
No, I'm teasing. No, Speedy and I, we met each other. Gosh, it's been a while. Good about 15
different clubs around the city.
Ago.
Just
seeing
her sing.
He never
and
tried.
And he used to, host shows for me. Yeah. And
Speedy
and
I bring
some great
she
things.
She always have, now I need you to bring me out with, I need all that.
Okay, well,
and he did it. And he did it.
I didn't want to do like in Purple Rain. Please put your hands together for Marva King.
You're funny.
So who is that? Like, you've been singing a while, and like, what's been like the most exciting part of your career? Who's been? Who have you been most excited about singing with or working with?
Well, I probably should probably politically say all of them, but no. The most fun I really have to say is with Prince, of course.
Wow.
If you guys have ever seen his shows, you know it's insane, right?
Right. Mm-hmm.
So he's one of the last of the Mohegans when it comes to that live performance area. So he would just let me do whatever I want, and sometimes he would create things on stage for me. And, I mean, I've done everything from leap off of six-foot monitors to run down plexiglass, like 20 stairs in the dark with stilettos on and
him or
I
you
stage dive. You crazy. Well, you know he did it, right? I did it too. And so he was like, if I could do it, you could do it too. And I did it. I only failed one time. I used to stage dive. He had me doing everything from singing to playing percussions to dancing. You know, so it was a lot of fun.
Now, what song did you sing on Diamonds and Pearls? What song did you sing?
No,
on
I didn't.
Prince?
It was Rosie Gaines. Actually, I couldn't touch that, you know, after the elitists have made their mark, you know, he kind of don't let anybody go behind them. And, and I respect that because he has such a strong respect for the artist.
Mm-hmm.
So, no, I didn't get a chance to sing. I could lip sync it. But no, you will not be heard in the house.
Oh, wow.
But, hilarious. But I sang. that's true. But,
How was he to work with?
But he was great to work with for me. You know, Prince is a taskmaster. You know, you cannot slack. You cannot be at all. dim-witted, dull. Everybody that works with him, I will tell you, they all have very high IQs because you will not last a day with him if you don't.
Really? Oh,
wow. That is so very true.
That's being quite intimidating, though.
It depends on who you are.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You're a dumb motherfucker. It ain't going to work for you.
What are he talking Murder. About? The big-ass words.
I need some money. But, no, I've seen many people, including myself, you know, we just rise to the occasion. Mm-hmm. You know, we just, wow, is this what is required? And those that can, you know, meet the demands, then you kind of hang around. So I go in and out. I started with him in the late 90s, 97, and I worked with him until 1999. And then I came back again in 2007 and did the O2 Arena and stayed
with
him.
So you would just do most of the tours?
Yeah, I would do tours. I did recordings too. Oh, okay. I've done several recordings. Matter of fact, he started a couple albums on me, and
I would just never finish them.
I don't want to do all this. I feel like Cyndi Lauper.
Do that again, please. Thank you. Appreciate that.
So now you have a new project out. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yes, definitely. Well, this is my first time. I've been independent for about 10 years now and had Marvelous Works Entertainment. And then I met a gentleman that has a company called Pearl Records. Mm-hmm. And we've joined forces and we're on Universal.
Wow.
And so on the 21st, which is just a couple days ago, my first single was released. It's called Steppin' from a CD called 360 Deal. Mm-mm. And those that are in the industry, you know what 360 Deal is about, right? I don't have one of those. I'm making fun of it because there's a rapper that talks about Marvin King and a 360 deal. Mm-hmm. So I'll let everybody check
Who?
It out.
What rapper?
There's a rapper that's on my CD.
Okay.
He's on my CD. And I just
What's his name?
His name is Ibizio.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Ibizio. Yeah,
how do you spell that again? It's an E in there somewhere.
Matter of fact, you know what I'm saying wrong. Ibizio. Ibizio or something like that.
Okay.
Just look it up. Google him. Well, he writes for a lot of rappers, though. Okay. So he's kind of, you'll be hearing of him because he's working on his own project, but he's really incredible. But he said a comment, and I was like, okay, that's crazy. And after about 4 months trying to figure out what the CD was going to be called, I titled it. I said 360 deal. Because people are going to say, she got a 360 deal. Long as she been in the business.
Explain to people what a 360 deal is.
A 360 deal is actually a deal that basically Lock, Stock, and Barrel owns the artist, the talent.
Wow.
And so that means
all their merchandising and all that.
Usually pretty much everything. Mm-hmm. That means artist rights. They usually get publishing. They usually have tour rights. Let's see.
They own you.
Intellectual property rights. Yeah, if you do acting, blah, 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 blah. But, you know, I've been around the business for a while.
Wow.
And I have a very good partner. So, you know, that wasn't even a conversation.
So some people do get caught in those deals because they don't know.
Are you
or
kidding?
They're not reading.
That's the deals of this age now.
Wow.
Generally, most new artists that come in, you know, that's what's presented to them, and they're not in a position to say no, they want a deal. You know, like when I first started, I was in my teens, and I signed a contract, didn't really know what I was signing. Mm-hmm. You know, I got out of it real quick because I was underage. How about that? I figured it out real quick. But now, 360 deals, especially in light of or in lieu of how the industry is, you know, right now with downloading and how the bootlegging and all those things like that are going on. People pretty much take the deals that they can get and get themselves established, and then they come back later, you know, and try to
redo it.
Yeah.
Now, last time we talked, you were getting into movies and television. You had the guy from England or from overseas that was going to back everything. Are you? You guys still working on?
Well, you know what? Actually, you're talking about David Lawrence. David Lawrence,
yes.
Actually, initially, he paid for one of my independent CDs to be recorded. Mm-hmm. He paid a part of it anyway.
Mm-hmm.
Paid for the recording. Mm-hmm. And so, no, we didn't go any further with that.
Because you wanted to get into movies and
Well, guess
acting.
What? Of course, my dear. And yes. Guess what's so wonderful? How I ended up meeting Chris LeMons, who is my business partner. Chris actually called me. I was in New York shopping a television show that's a cooking entertainment show.
Because
you know I'm always doing shopping.
Yeah,
I always got something brewing. And while I was in New York, he called me to actually do a show that's like a entertainment show that's about music. It's about soul of Black American music and where it derived from, and actually music in general. And all music come from the continent of Africa, and mm-hmm. you know, it's influenced every genre of music. So that's how we started. And now that show is called Soul of American Music, SAM, And it's going to be, we're shooting our first episodes in about 2 weeks.
Oh, dope.
So all I'll right. be co-hosting that with him. And it's going to be great. We're doing a tribute to Sam Cooke first. That's how we're starting. So we're going to have all these artists, including myself. We're going to be doing Sam Cooke songs and doing the tribute for, you know, one of the masters.
Okay.
And then in terms of films, I have a film called Heat on the Delta that I'm going to start shooting in May. We start pre-production. Fall is the shoot. So it's going to be a very good role for myself and everyone that's in the cast, because it's a true story. It starts, it's a period piece. It starts like in the early 1900s and goes up to the 1940s. And you see blacks, not just sharecroppers, that are very couture, dressed in clubs, and, you know, and you see some of them that are wealthy. But then also you'll deal with the trials and tribulations of the sharecroppers of that time. So this That's will be a different perspective we'll see for black
Americans. Good job, Marva.
Okay, cool. Now you have a new single, Stepping. Can you tell us about that? We're going to get into it.
Sure. Stepping is a song that I co-wrote and co-produced with a gentleman by the name of Stone. His name is Corey Paxton, for real.
Okay.
And I wanted a stepper song because I love Sade and I love R. Kelly's music.
Mm-hmm.
So had to clarify that.
Okay. Wouldn't let him babysit, but
wouldn't never let him come near the babies.
Kiss in the name of love. But,
oh, that's Coco. I didn't say that.
But, jump up in the name of love.
Hopscotch in the name of love.
Anyway, so we're going to get into that now.
But anyway, she said, come on, y'all, with it. But yeah, so I end up co-writing this song and producing it and recorded the whole entire CD over the last 4 or 5 months because I'm a writer, producer, and I cut most of my tracks too, which is, that's a job.
Okay.
And I'm just coming out. I'm just peeping my head out of the studio as of the last like month. So Stepping ended up getting chosen by radio. And I'm featuring Christopher Williams and a new rapper that's coming along named Alpha Red, who he's like the light-skinned brother. We're bringing light-skinned and sexy back.
Okay. Oh, cool. Well,
he actually got this. Everybody keeps saying he reminds him of Heavy D. Everybody say, oh, he reminds me of Heavy D.
Well, that's a good thing.
Yeah, it's a very good thing. Yes. But he's very good. He's local. Los Angeles.
Okay. We're going to get into your single now. Okay. It's Step In. I'll reach around radio and we'll be
Marva
back.
King.
Marva King in the building.
World. It is MK. Stepping up. Now set your drinks down for this one. We about to cut a rug. Yeah.
When you call me, baby, you know I'm done. Yeah. I got your message, so I'm on my